Bouts of bad weather hampered progress on the permanent waywork around the line, but by late August, the railway had been reopened to the newly rebuilt Axley station, and work at the junction had finally been completed. All that was left to do was finish repairing the track work to Colhapper, which Allan had been working very hard to finish. One stormy Sunday evening in September 1970, Allan returned to Mirkham Sheds in high spirits, bustling in looking very pleased with himself. Ryan looked sceptical. "Why are you so happy, mate? It's a miserable day."
"Have a guess."
"Go on." "Did you ask Five out on a date or something? I know you've been spending a lot of time with him and..."
"Don't be an idiot, Ryan. We finished it."
"Finished what?"
"The track repairs to Colhapper."
Ryan seemed puzzled for a moment, then it clicked.
"Oh! You finished the repairs?"
"That's what I said. Mr. Dark and the DRPS and chairman have signed off the work this afternoon. The permanent way gangs have done a fabulous job, aided by me, of course."
"And Phil and Otto, who've probably done all the heavy shunting work at Soma, and Five, who've been helping at the junction, and Eddie, who've been bringing the trains of ballast and steel down for you."
"Don't take this away from me, Ryan."
Ryan chuckled.
"Anyway, overheard Mr. Dark and Mr. Chairman speaking at the junction. They're planning a reopening train over the new extension soon."
At these words, Carcass Smash, who had been resting a few shed roads away chatting to Dave, perked up.
"Ah, a special train. I suppose Mr. Dark will ask me to take it."
"Not bloody likely, mate. I bet I'll be asked to take it."
Carcass frowned.
"But you're a mixed traffic engine."
"You're a mixed traffic engine too, dude."
"But I..."
"No ifs, no buts. We're both mixed traffic engines, so either one of them could be asked to take the train."
"Hmm, I suppose you're right. But I do feel that it would be more appropriate for a large engine like myself to take it."
"Keep dreaming, buddy. If anything, Turbo will probably take it. Or Raymond, if he doesn't break down again or complain about his drafty cab."
It turned out Dave was wrong, however. Mr. Dark approached the sheds one morning whilst the engines were being prepared for work. He approached Allan, who was speaking to Lino regarding some trucks at the junction the previous day, and was surprised to see Mr. Dark approaching him, fearing a bollocking about said trucks.
"Good morning, Allan."
"Look, sir, if it's about those trucks, Lino can tell you. They were being rude and obnoxious to ground staff, and I wasn't going to take that."
"No, Allan, it's not about the tr..."
"Wait, what happened?"
Allan sighed.
"Doesn't matter, sir. What's up?"
"Allan, I've come to speak to you about something quite special which I'd like you to do."
Allan looked dubious as some of the other engines looked over.
"And what would that be, sir?"
"Well, as you know, I'm planning a special reopening service to Colhapper to take place next week, and I wanted to ask you if you'd like to pull that first train up to Colhapper from the junction."
The other engines looked completely shocked, none more so than Carcass Smash.
Allan thought about this for a moment.
"Are you sure, sir? I'm not a passenger engine after all, and I've never pulled a passenger train before."
"Look, Allan, you've been working extremely hard over the last few months with the permanent way team. You've spent entire nights out there to make sure that the work is done, and you've shown true commitment to your work. Because of that, I cannot think of a more appropriate engine to take that first train over the new extension."
Allan looked abashed.
Well, sir, I'd love to."
"Fabulous! Now, the problem is we have no runround facilities at Colhapper at present, so this first train will need to be top and tailed. So I'm leaving it to you to decide who'd like to go with you, Allan."
Allan looked around at his friends, who all looked expectantly at him. He found it difficult just then to decide who he wanted to help him with that first train, and faltered.
Mr. Dark looked up at him. "Well, I'll give you a few days to make a decision, Allan, all right?"
"Yes, sir."
"Excellent. Now then, I better get back to work. This paperwork's driving me mental."
Mr. Dark strode away. Allan turned his attention back to the other engines, who were all looking at him in an unusual way. Then Dave spoke.
"So then, Allan, old buddy, old pal, who are you thinking about to take the train with you?"
I really don't know."
"Well, I've always been very supportive of you, Allan, and I am one of your best friends, after all."
"When have you ever been supportive of me?"
"Well, there was that one time. You've never been supportive of Allan, Dave. I, meanwhile, am actually properly Allan's best friend. Isn't that right, mate?"
"Well, yeah, you are my best friend."
"So, you wanted me to help you with the special train, then?"
Well, I think that I could give you a hand, Allan. You know, being a bigger diesel than you means I can give you some actual help, unlike Ryan, who isn't anywhere near powerful enough to help you out."
I'll have you know that I pulled a passenger train once when you broke down at Soma. That was over 10 years ago, Ryan. Let go of the past.
I think you're all forgetting, chaps, that passengers will want to see a steam engine working this opening train. I'm sure Allan will accept my offer to come with you, won't you, Allan?
I'm not going to lie, Lino, you are rather small and old. What does age have to do with this? I'm still a capable engine, but not as capable as me. If any engine here should take that first train, it's me. I don't see why I shouldn't have a shot. I'm a suburban passenger engine after all, so I'd be more of a help for accelerating away from the stations and giving Allan a push if he needs it. Aren't we all forgetting that I'm painted in the railway's house colours? Therefore, I'd be better for advertising.
But you're a lazy bastard, as you said yourself.
So are you!
Well, I'm certainly not a lazy engine. Therefore, my offer still stands, doesn't it, Allan?
Allan was very upset. He knew that everybody wanted a shot at being on the first train to Colhapper, but he didn't want to be part of any arguments, or cause any, among the other engines. He slept at Woolchurch that night, thinking. The next day, he rolled cautiously down to Axley, where Hannah was waiting to take a passenger train back up the line. She hadn't been at the shed the previous day, but he knew that she had probably heard the news from Dave and the others.
All right, Hannah.
Hello, Allan. Are you feeling okay today?
Yeah, no, not really.
I didn't think you would. I heard about what happened.
You're not going to try and convince me to choose you too, are you?
Absolutely not. I've got no interest in publicity stunts, to be honest. You deserve to be able to make your own choice as to who helped you.
I know. I just don't want to cause any arguments or upsets with anybody. And I know what everyone's trying to do. Pretending to like me just so they can go beyond the junction.
Nobody's pretending to like you, Allan. We all like you. And likewise, we all know how hard you've been working recently. I think everybody's just excited about the extension, of course. But being first isn't the be-all and end-all.
Then, what do I do? Who do I choose? I need to pick someone.
Think of engines who have been working as hard as you have, and those who have been sincere at the moment, and you'll find that you can make the right decision. Good luck, Allan.
Thanks, Hannah. I'll think about it.
Hannah hurried away as Allan rolled off to the junction to be alone and think a little. For the next few days, Allan kept a close eye on everyone. Dave, surprisingly, had shut up about the whole thing, but he suspected that was more to do with Hannah telling him off about getting in Allan's face. Ryan, too, apologised for unintentionally upsetting his best friend and agreed to help Allan think of someone who deserved to be helping out on that special train. After much deliberation, Allan finally made a choice and sought out Mr. Dark late in the evening.
Sir?
Hello, Allan.
Sir, I've made a decision on who I'd like to help me pull that special train.
Oh, really? And who would that be? Allan paused for a moment, then told Mr. Dark who he'd chosen.
So you're sure then?
Absolutely.
Then I'll make sure the necessary arrangements are made.
Thank you, Allan.
Quite alright, sir. Just, can you keep it a secret until the day?
Of course. The morning of the special to Colhapper arrived. Allan, who wasn't hauling the train until it arrived at Gallen Junction, had left early to wait at the station. Time went by, and soon he heard an engine approaching.
Oh, hello you!
Allan, why did you choose me to do this? I told you I didn't like publicity stunts.
Oh, I know, but I thought this would be the best way.
Why?
I thought it'd be better that someone who didn't want to do it should do it. That way the others won't feel too bad about it. Also, despite what you told me, I think you've been working really hard over the last few months. And of course, of everybody, you are the most supportive of me. So this is my thank you for helping me make my choice.
Hannah didn't know what to say, but she didn't have to say anything as Allan smiled at her. But then he frowned.
I'm well nervous, Hannah. I've never pulled a passenger train before.
You'll be fine, Allan. I'm at the back of the train if you need me. If you need any help, just toot your horn.
Alrighty. Thanks, Hannah.
So Hannah headed for the rear of the train, whilst Allan was coupled up at the front. Mr. Dark, Mr. Smash, and Mr. Chairman had all come down to the front of the train to see Allan. Nervous?
Very.
No need to be, Allan. I'm sure you'll do great.
And we all agree that you are indeed the most appropriate engine to take the first train to Colhapper. After everything you've done with the Preservation Society to get this railway back on track, so to speak, you truly deserve to be the first engine to haul the passengers over the extension.
Good luck, Allan.
Thank you, sirs.
Once everybody went back on board, the guard waved his flag, and Allan roared into life. It felt very strange to be taking coaches out of what was once the main line, but he knew that, nervous or not, he wanted to do Mr. Dark proud. Smiling to himself and feeling rather exposed, he hurried away along the line. Allan began to struggle as he approached the incline outside the station, so he tooted his horn so that Hannah could help him. She did so, and soon they were over the top and coasting down towards the large town of Colhapper. As they approached, Allan was shocked to see that on their newly acquired platform, hundreds of people were waiting to watch him arrive. Some snapped pictures as he entered the station, whilst others took video with their big cameras. Despite his nerves, Allan couldn't help grinning as he came to a stop at the far end of the platform. Mr. Dark, Mr. Smash, and Mr. Chairman all walked up to him.
Very well done indeed, Allan.
Thanks, Mr. Smash, but Hannah did most of the work. We heard, but still, first time putting a passenger train then, Allan. How did it feel?
Pretty good actually, sir.
Very impressive stuff. Now then, gentlemen, I suppose we'd better make our speeches.
Indeed, we should. The three men made a very long and boring speech in the middle of the platform, congratulating the efforts of the Dark Railway Preservation Society for their work on the extension, bigging up Mr. Dark for his purchase of the line and part of the station, and managing to publicise Mr. Smash slightly for his work too. Allan fell asleep partway through this speech, but was woken up again as his name was called. And I'd like to make a personal thank you to a very special engine today. Without his help, none of this would have been made possible today, due to his hard work on the repairs to the track work between here and Gallon Junction. So, I'd like to lead a round of applause for my diesel shunter, Allan. Allan awoke as a thunderous applause rang out around the station. The multiple unit in the other platform sneered, but Allan ignored him as Mr. Dark continued to address the crowd, thanking Hannah for her help that day too. Eventually, it was time to head back to Mirkum. Allan helped to bank Hannah out of the station, but was very tired afterwards. Instead of being uncoupled at Gallon Junction, Hannah offered to take him back to Mirkum with the train, for which he was very grateful indeed. When they arrived back, Allan was uncoupled, but didn't immediately depart for the sheds. He was worried about how the other engines would react to his decision. Hannah, though, wasn't having any of it.
Come on, Allan, I'm sure everything will be fine.
But what if it's not?
Then I'll crush their cylinders against the shed walls.
Alright, calm down.
However, to Alan's surprise, everybody seemed rather happy to see the pair of them. Allan, Hannah, how'd it go?
Very well indeed.
Mr. Dark seems happy with the investment at least.
Did he do one of those boring speeches?
Of course he did. I nearly dozed off at one point.
And how was it for you, Allan?
Interesting, I guess. I've never pulled coaching before. Pretty boring compared to shunting and P-Way. And what's the extension like? It's only about 2 miles at most. Not really anything interesting to see.
I can agree with that. Not the most thrilling section of railway. But it's still a longer run for us, and gives us somewhere to somewhere runs at long last.
Think I'll stick to my shunting jobs in future, mind. You lot sure you're not mad about my decision, by the way?
Nah.
We decided that Hannah was indeed the best engine to help you out after all. She didn't make any fuss about it, unlike us.
I told you it'd be fine, Allan.
Gee, thanks everyone. Guess didn't have to anything to worry about after all.
Of course not, Allan. We're all friends, remember?
Yes, we are. Thanks everyone.
Allan settled down that evening feeling much happier that his decision hadn't led to any upsets or arguments. Besides, he thought to himself, the other engines would all get their chance to run to Colhapper in time. He, meanwhile, was perfectly happy to do his shunting jobs, and let the big engine get on with pulling trains.